the second part of Unit 6 deals with acids and bases. Acids and bases are an extremely important part of chemistry. This is also, some might consider, the most challenging part of the course. I also find it the most fun. So hopefully I can teach it in such a way that you enjoy it and that you learn what you need to know. So first of all, when you think about something like, when I say an acid, a lot of times you think about like HCl. Think, oh, well, that's an acid. Well, HCl is actually called hydrogen chloride. Hydrogen chloride. And when you go into the storeroom, the stock room, there's, you can find some powder that's a white powder. That's hydrogen chloride powder. Okay, what makes hydrogen chloride an acid is based on one of the definitions of what an acid is. Because when you put hydrogen chloride into water, what it does is it breaks apart into hydrogen ions and chloride ions. Okay, and so an acid, there's two basic definitions that we're going to learn about acids. One of them, the most basic way that you learn about acids, is what's called the Arrhenius definition, or an Arrhenius acid or base. An Arrhenius acid is one that when you put it into water, so when it dissolves in water, it produces hydrogen ions, or what we call hydronium ions. Notice I wrote it here as H+. Really what happens is you have an H2O molecule where basically another hydrogen is added onto it. And so a lot of times you'll just write it as H+, but a lot of times they will write it as H3O plus as well. That's actually the correct way of writing it. This is just kind of the quicker way of writing it. But H plus, when dissolved in water, is really H3O plus, which we call hydronium. Okay, so when something is an acid, it means that when you put it into water, it creates hydronium ions. Okay, and when something is a base, such as NaOH, you put that into water, what does it do? Well, it's soluble, so it breaks apart into Na plus and OH minus. And so a base is something that when you put it into water, it produces hydroxide ions, or OH minus. And we talked way back at the beginning of the year about strong acids and weak acids, and strong bases and weak bases. We're going to get into that a little bit more here in this unit as well. For right now, HCl is a strong acid. You know that. That should be one of the seven you remember. And sodium hydroxide does have that alkali metal in it, so it is completely soluble. So you do get those hydroxide ions in there as well. Now, I don't want to say a better way, but a different way, a more common way for you to understand what's an acid and what's a base is based on what's called the Bronsted-Lowry definition. Okay, and a Bronsted-Lowry acid is one that donates the hydrogen ion. It's a proton. If you think about an H+, think about what that atom looks like. It's got the proton in the middle and no neutrons, and it's lost the electron it had. So that's a hydrogen ion is really nothing more than a proton. Okay, and so when they call it an acid, they call it a proton donor. It's basically something that gives up its hydrogen ion and something else takes it. The other thing that takes it is the base. The base is the proton acceptor. Okay, so let me show you what I mean here. Okay, so and if you look at this example, you've got HNO3 and H2O. Notice on the other side what happens to the HNO3? It becomes NO3 minus. What happened? The HNO3 donated its proton. It gave away its proton. Okay, and that makes HNO3 an acid. And what did H2O do from this side to this side? It started as H2O, it became H3O plus, and therefore it accepted that hydrogen ion. That makes H2O the base. Okay, so the one that gives up the hydrogen is an acid, the one that accepts the hydrogen is the base. Okay, and again, oftentimes you'll see that H plus will be written instead of the whole H3O plus. They mean the same thing. Okay, here's another example of this. You've got NH3 and H2O. Okay, notice again, just look at it on the other side. What does NH3 become? It becomes NH4 plus. So therefore, it accepted a hydrogen ion. So that makes NH3 the base. Notice that water in this case, what did water do? Water went from H2O to OH minus. It lost that hydrogen. It donated that hydrogen. So therefore, that makes H2O the acid. Okay, and you might notice right away, wait a minute. Up here you said H2O is a base. Down here you said H2O is an acid. Okay, sometimes things can act as both. Sometimes it can act as a Bronsted acid, and it can also act as a Bronsted base. Okay, when something can do that, what's that called? That's called amphoteric. Not nothing that you anything you need to memorize. But if something has the ability to donate a hydrogen and also to accept a hydrogen, that makes it an amphoteric. Okay, so something like H2PO4 minus. That could accept another hydrogen to become H3PO4. It could also lose another hydrogen to become HPO4 2 minus. Okay, something like H2O, we just saw that. It can become H3O plus, it could also become OH minus. Okay, both of those are amphoteric. If something doesn't have the ability to either lose another hydrogen or it can't gain another hydrogen, then it can't be amphoteric. Like, for example, the ammonium ion. The ammonium ion can lose a hydrogen to become NH3, but nitrogen can't form more than four bonds. So it can't become NH5 2+. That doesn't happen. Okay, so therefore NH4+, not amphoteric. Okay, so if something can gain a hydrogen and also lose a hydrogen, then that can be considered amphoteric. Okay, now, when you have a Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction, where you've got one thing that's donating the hydrogen, something else that's accepting the hydrogen, we can also talk about the things on the other side of the equation. Okay, every acid has, on the opposite side, has what's called a conjugate base. Okay, OH minus is the whatever the acid turns into, it turns into, after it donates its hydrogen, to the conjugate base on the product side. So this OH minus here is what we call the conjugate base. Okay, and the base, after accepting the hydrogen, turns into, so that NH4 plus is the conjugate acid. Okay, so in every Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction, there's an acid and a base, and there's also a conjugate acid and a conjugate base. Now, how do you know if the reaction is a Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction? Because something has to lose a hydrogen and something else has to gain that hydrogen. Okay? So, in every acid-base reaction, we can identify two sets of conjugate acid-base, what are called acid-base pairs. Okay, in this reaction, HNO2 becomes NO2 minus, so therefore that's the acid, and I'm just going to use C period. And therefore, NO2 minus is the conjugate base. Water is the base, and therefore H3O plus is the conjugate acid. Because remember, guys, this is equilibrium. So not only does this reaction go this way, it's also, as you start to form that NO2 minus and the H3O plus, the reaction starts to go back the other way as well. So there needs to be an acid and a base on both sides. And just to distinguish between the reactant side and the product side, they use acid and base for the left-hand side and conjugate acid and conjugate base for the right-hand side. Okay, examples 1 and 2. Again, this would be a good point for you to pause the video and try to do this yourself, and then come back and watch me do it. So in example 1, it says identify each acid-base conjugate pair in the following reaction and justify your choices. Well, NH3 goes from NH3 to NH4+. Therefore, it accepted the hydrogen. So therefore, it is the base. And therefore, this is the conjugate acid. So one acid-base conjugate pair would be NH3 and NH4+. Okay, that's one possible choice. Okay, and then H2O, notice it goes from H2O to OH minus, so it gave up a hydrogen, so therefore that makes it an acid, and this is therefore the conjugate base. So another acid-base conjugate pair is H2O and OH minus. Okay, and then to justify your answer, you could simply say that NH3 gained a hydrogen ion, and therefore it's a base that becomes a conjugate acid. H2O donates a hydrogen ion, and therefore it is an acid forming a conjugate base. Okay, and then example number two, it says sodium azide is an ionic compound that can be synthesized from hydroxyoic acid as represented by the net ionic equation below, blah, blah, blah. Okay, and notice they did leave the sodium out. There is no sodium there. And again, they're showing the net ionic equation, that's why. The student believes that this is an acid-base reaction and claims that HN3 and H2O are an acid-base conjugate pair. Do you agree or disagree with this claim that the two compounds are an acid-base conjugate pair? So, first of all, the student believes this is an acid-base reaction. Is it an acid-base reaction? Let's see. HN3 goes from HN3 to N3 minus. It donated a hydrogen, so it gave up a hydrogen, so that makes it an acid, and that makes this its conjugate base. And OH minus gained a hydrogen from here to here, so that makes this the base, and water the conjugate acid. Okay, and so the acid-base conjugate pairs would be HN3 and N3 minus would be one of the conjugate pairs, and then OH minus and H2O would be the other conjugate pair. So the student claims that the HN3 and H2O are an acid-base conjugate pair. Absolutely not. We're going to disagree with that statement. And we could simply say, well, because it's not the conjugate base of HN3 is not H2O, it's N3 minus. Okay, you could also say a conjugate base has one less hydrogen ion than the acid, which it does, one less hydrogen ion. Or you could also say a conjugate acid would have one more hydrogen ion than the base. Again, lots of different ways you can explain it correctly. Or you could simply say, no, the H2O is not the conjugate acid of HN3, it's OH minus are the conjugate acid base pairs in that reaction.